So comedy is really important. I think sometimes people don't take it as seriously, but in my opinion, comedy is a lot harder than tragedy. Your timing has to be much more precise. Your intention, the actions behind what you're doing on stage, and your focus on the other person has to be a lot more intense in order for the audience to really buy it and think that that's funny. I think it's important because people need to laugh. We all need that release. So even if it seems silly, it's serving a very important purpose in our lives.
It's definitely brought out some sides of me that I didn't think were there.
I suppose it hasn't been too bad. I mean, he's not that temperamental. He's not really a diva or anything, so that's nice. The hardest part is just making sure that we all know exactly where he is, because he doesn't make a lot of noise, obviously. So we have to decide where he is.
Well, Harvey has really become like a member of our cast, just like anyone else, and I think that, you know, he really adds this sort of life to the play, this sort of mystery that there's just this rabbit walking around, and, you know, he could be sitting right here next to me, and I don't know. But, you know, Harvey is really something magical, and that's really what makes this play special.
Would the one who has a six foot one and a half invisible bunny as a best friend the insane one? Or is the man who doesn't notice that the love of his life is standing right beside him the crazy one? Is it the man who always dreams about being someplace else all day long? Is that the crazy one who can't find happiness, whereas Elwood is always happy wherever he is with whatever he's doing? Who's the crazy one? The social climber who's willing to commit her brother, who's perfectly sweet and harmless, so that she can have a better social life and get ahead? Who's crazy? So I would say those are the main themes of Harvey.